to church. My name's Pastor Don, this is Pastor Adrian. We're senior ministers. Oh, hang on a second. For the next 45
we
minutes.
We are, for the next hour or so. We're the senior ministers of T3 Robina. That feels really weird saying that.
To set the scene, we're here today to induct Josh and Kate, to impart, to confer, and to see the Spirit of God come upon them. And what better space as they take up the role of senior ministers than in worship with a community of faith, people
yes.
gathered from other churches, people, friends who have come from far and near. So what a beautiful thing it is that we can gather together and enjoy the presence of God together.
Absolutely wonderful. It's great. Thank you to you if you are watching online,
yeah,
joining us online. Welcome.
We're so glad you're here.
Yes.
And enjoying this time with us. Hey, it's time to worship God. So there's a great song. Ben, thank you for all your preparation. This is all about being home. So welcome home to God's house.
Please stand. Let's worship together.
From the cold, from my broken road, you welcomed me in and you made me your own. The heat of your fire melted my soul. All of this time, this is where I belong. Oh, I am found. Oh, so I sing it. Together we say, oh Father. we are home. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Jesus. In the presence of my enemies, I'll raise a hallelujah louder than the unbelief. I'll raise a hallelujah. Oh, my weapon is a melody. I'll raise a hallelujah. Heaven comes to fight for me. I'm gonna sing. I'm gonna sing in the middle of the storm.
In the presence of my enemies.
Yes, 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 yes. Wonderful. Thank you, Lord. God, you're good. We thank you for your incredible love.
And you carry us on
the King
journey.
Is alive.
No matter what the circumstance,
God, thank you.
Father, you are there. You never leave
thank
us
you, Father.
Nor forsake us, but
I thank you
are
you, Father.
There. And we praise you, God. We lift you. We applaud you. We bless you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
Holy
Lord.
God, we welcome you.
Yes.
Into this place.
Yes. Let's welcome our God to this
thank
place today.
God.
Come on, let's raise our
thank you, God.
Clap our hands. Shout unto him with a voice of triumph.
Bless you, God.
We welcome you, Lord.
Bless you, God.
Wonderful.
Bless you. Bless you, Jesus.
Wonderful. Would you like to be seated for a moment? What a special day.
Oh, what a special day. It really is. Thank you so much, everybody, for being here today. So good to see so many faces that are wonderfully familiar.
Just beautiful.
Beautiful people.
Thank you.
People we've journeyed with over the years. And we would like to say a special mention of a few people, some people. Bear with us if we miss you. Sorry. We've got some greetings from people, yeah. Though, some C3 ministers who could not be here today. Pastor Gordon and Joe Moore, who are senior ministers emeritus of Bridgeman Downs.
And Nick and Mel Hines send their greetings from Bill Connon, and they're part of the C3 Australia team.
Yes, Pastors Bruce and Julie Williams from Adelaide Hills.
And Sarah Michael Williams from Queanbeyan.
Also Richard and Sue Botter from Carlingford, who are also the Southeast Asia directors.
And also our local Member of Parliament sends her greetings, Ros Bates. Sends her
yes.
Congratulations to Josh and Kate.
She wasn't able to be here today.
I want to say a special welcome to those, some dignitaries who are with us today, some civic and business leaders.
Councillor Glenn Tozer.
And Jude.
And Jude and their boys.
Glad
welcome.
Thank you. Hayden Whitworth from City Impact. Thank you for attending, sir. And
Graham Thompson from Kingdom Accounting.
Thank you, Graham. Helping us keep safe. And business leaders and educators. We're so glad that you've come and to share this time with us. I want to make mention of some C3 pastors who are with us. And a special welcome to Pastor Andrew McGruver. From Bridgman Downs Lighthouse, who is also our Queensland, Northern New South Wales Regional Director. We're so glad that you've come for this special occasion today.
Pastors Steve and Deb White, who are our overseers of this church.
Yeah. Yeah.
And also founders of C3 Kingscliff.
And Stephen Christie Godfrey from Kingscliff. Yeah.
Eric and Chris Harrison, founders of C3 Currumbin.
Yeah, and Dan and Hannah, who are at Currumbin, and Dawn. Hey, Dawn.
Isaac and Lauren Frankham from Byron Bay.
Yes. So glad you guys are here, and the kids, welcome. Stephen Sonny, who... we're founders at Inner East. We're glad you're here, Stephen Simon.
Yep.
Thank you. Yes. I know. It's good.
And Chris Wiggins, who is now at Inner East.
Yeah. So I don't know if you realise, but in the room there's founders and there's people who are now looking after churches and that is a beautiful thing, and to me that's a safe thing.
Yep.
As we together come and celebrate.
Matt and Creone Hickson,
yeah.
From Springfield.
Yeah.
She's here.
Springfield.
I saw her. I know she's here. And
James and Donna from
Pimpamar. James and Donna Blair. Yeah.
Thank you.
Pimpamar.
Great to have you here. Thank you.
Also, welcome to colleagues from other Gold Coast churches. This is just wonderful. Shane and Gemma Cookle and their family from Mosaic Baptist Church.
Thank you. Great to have you here, guys. Really pleased. Thank you for coming.
And Len Rosso from Genesis Church.
Founder of Genesis.
Founder.
Pastor Len, we go back a long way. Thank you. Many years. Yes.
Just want to say an awfully, awesomely, a wonderful welcome to our own family, Kate and Ash, who worship here, and their boys, but also Sarah and Matt, who have come down from Brisbane to worship with us today at this special occasion.
This is so special.
It's just beautiful to have our whole family here. Yeah.
Thank you. And speaking.
And also, special welcome to Pat. And Stuart. Pat is Kate's mum. So it's great to have Kate here.
Wonderful. To those who are here today as former leaders and former members, we want to say thank you for your part in the journey. Thank you for coming today to celebrate with us. We value that so much and appreciate you and want to applaud you today.
Yes, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And a huge welcome to our current members. They're the best. Woo-hoo-hoo. And especially for everything you've done. It's just been such a lot of hard work, for our team, making this
so
service
beautiful.
Special, and also next week's service as well.
Yeah, and the party continues.
Yes.
And if this is your first time, welcome.
Woo-hoo.
If your first time here, then we're glad you're here. So big welcome to God's house.
Thank you all for being here today. Your affirmation of the appointment of Josh and Kate as senior ministers of C3 Robina and your support reinforces our belief that our churches and our communities have a wonderful future as we work together for God's purposes.
Yeah, we're going to hear now from some of the young people. So can I invite Sarah, one of our youth leader, and some of the young guys to come? You got something we'd like to...
Hey, friends. How we doing? Hey. Awesome. Can we ask Josh and Kate to come up on stage? We just couldn't let this opportunity pass without saying that we love you. And we're so excited for this new season. It's going to be incredible. The youth wanted to be able to give you something. Youth being youth don't have much money, but they have words and paper. So they have written you cards encouraging you, cheering you on. So keep that somewhere special.
And we found a scripture that we felt God was saying, "For I am the Lord your God who takes hold of your right hand and says to you, do not fear, I will help you."
Beautiful. There you go. Yeah, that's so beautiful.
We love you guys.
Thank you.
Thank you, Alicia and Sarah.
That is awesome. We're going to spend a moment in prayer. It's one of the great things that people do. They sing songs to our God. We love to pray together. And I've invited some of our pastor friends to come and join us and lead us in prayer today. So can we stand together? And those who are praying, would you please come and join us here on stage? Christy, would you like to kick off and lead us in prayer?
My honour. Let's pray together this morning. We're going to just pray for our churches all over this nation and also in our movement, C3.
Yes.
So, Lord God, we just thank you for the church, for the great plan that you had for planet Earth. God, we are so grateful to be a part of it. And, Lord, we know that the greatest days are ahead. And so, Lord, right now in this moment, we thank you for our nation. We thank you globally for every C3 church. Lord, and we just pray that this would be a new fruitful season. God, where disciples discipleship, Lord, would be flourishing, Lord God, that the name of Jesus would be lifted high over every church, God, and that we would see so much fruit coming into your house, Lord. And I just thank you, Jesus, Lord, that your name is the name above every other name, God, and that we will continue to build and stand together until our dying days, Lord, to see your name lifted high. And so we just thank you for this season ahead, and we just pray for your church that it is a great time for our churches in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Hannah, would you pray for our city? Pray for our city and our civic leaders.
Amen. Lord, we just lift up those who are leading the way. God, those people who are appointed by you, our leadership, those ones that you have chosen and positioned. And Lord, we just lift them up with our prayers. God, we just pray that you would lift up their arms as we pray, that you would fill them with your wisdom. God, you would lead them along paths of righteousness, even though they may not even realize, God, that you would lead their decisions. You would impress things, heavenly things, God things, your heart upon their heart, that they would make decisions that would glorify you, maybe even without even realizing. God, we just thank you that they are leading the way. And God, we just pray and support them and lift them up.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Chris, would you pray for people to come to know Jesus?
Yes, Lord. Thank you, King. God, I just pray right now for this church, the people of this church, Lord God. Thank you that you would grant us, Lord God, to continually to declare your word with boldness, mighty God, that you would stretch out your hand to perform signs and wonders in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord God. I thank you that this church, quite literally, the people of this church would be a city on a hill, Lord God, shining the light and the love of Jesus into this city, into this region, mighty God. I thank you Monday through Sunday, Lord God, daily, Lord God, in the interactions, I thank you for a great boldness upon your people to share Jesus, to declare the good news of Jesus. And Lord, we thank you, Lord God, that you are in those moments, you are on those moments. I thank you for every seed that has been sown, Lord God, and the harvest that is to come on the other side of it. For every family member, co-worker, Lord God, every friend right now that we're believing for, we pray, ready their heart, prepare their heart, draw them to yourselves, open their eyes to behold you, Jesus Christ, Lord, Messiah of their life. We just thank you, mighty God. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And Matt, would you pray for the Eastons? Would you do that?
Let's pray for the Eastons. We're going to start by praying for Don and Adrian and then Josh and Kate. Father, we thank you that you place your spirit within your people. And we thank you for Don and Adrian. We thank you for all the sacrifice. We thank you for everything that they have poured out into building your church. We pray for them that you would just surround, cover, and fill every part of their world. God, we pray that you would cause them to become more fruitful than they've ever been. Would you strengthen them for this next season? Would you give them fresh revelation and renewed vision and strength as they step into the next chapter of your calling for their lives? Thank you for everything they've done, and thank you for what they will continue to bring to the body of Christ through the empowering of your Holy Spirit. And Father, we thank you for this great privilege of watching the baton get passed to Josh and Kate and their beautiful family. God, we just thank you that you have anointed them for this day, for this time, for this hour. We thank you, Holy Spirit, that you have filled them and you continue to fill them. We thank you that you would give them wisdom, that you would give them discernment, that you would give them understanding. You would give them the spiritual ability to see what others can't see, and that you would strengthen them, that you would cause their world and their lives to be prosperous, to be fruitful. And Father, we just pray, we surround them in faith right now. We surround them as their community, as their family, and we believe with them. And we thank you, God, for what you are going to do in and through this amazing couple and this church. And everyone said,
amen, amen. Wonderful. Thank you. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you. Please have a seat. So we've been singing some songs to our Lord. We've been talking to him in prayer.
The next thing to do is to bring of our lives to Him and bring of our offerings to Him. So we're coming to a time of giving. You're part of a local church, please send your tithes, take your tithes to your local church. This is a time of giving to our God and saying, God, thank you for who you are and what you've done in our lives. God is a God who is our shepherd. And as a result of that, we know this, we shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. If you don't know the Lord as your shepherd, my prayer is today you'd know Him, and that through that you'd discover that He would care for you in every aspect of your life. There's many ways you can give. You can use the QR code, you can go online, you can go to the FPOS machine at the cafe, you can put cash in a bucket, and you can sort it out, you're big people. Giving is being misunderstood often, and it's a curious thing that when churches come to talk about money, that people can get quite edgy about it. And some would say the church is just after your money. And if that's the case, then abuse needs to be called out, because we must never be under compulsion or under coercion in terms of giving of our financial resources. That's what needs to be said. But pastors need many competencies, and it's most complex, the roles that we have. I remember in our early days, just after we started, sitting with a bank manager, going for a bank loan, and going, he goes, how does that work? Like you're a church and you get your money from a church, and it's like what's your product? You know, what are you selling? It's like where's the widget? You know, like the trying to get his head around it. And I go, well you're right, we don't have much in the way of assets as a church. You know, the bank managers look at the asset register, and he wanted to know whether it's reliable in terms of income to be able to supply a loan. And he was going through it with a fine tooth comb, and he says, there's no assets here on the register. You know, have your assets, your liabilities. Well, we don't have liabilities either. You know, we just pay a bit of rent, and that's pretty cool. But people are just generous. And I remember saying to him, our asset is the people. Our asset is people whose names are written on another ledger, and that's the ledger of heaven. Written in the Lamb's Book of Life, people who belong to the kingdom of heaven. And he was a little perplexed at that. We are a people whose lives have experienced God's love. Here's a scripture I want to share with you this morning this afternoon. It is, maybe it's this morning in England. G'day to you guys. Love you being here with us. We love because He first loved us. Would you say this after me? We love.
We love.
Because he
first loved us.
You know, it's like I've received His love and I want others to experience it. That's my translation of that. When you know God's love, and when you've been touched by God's love, you want to do what you can do to help others experience that. And so we give of our lives to Him. You know, we left our comfort zone, our homes, South Australia, our family, our mums and dads, and our brothers and sisters and family, friends, and hopped in the XF Ford wagon and drove with Sarah at 6 and Josh at 4 and Kate at 2, came to this land that wasn't familiar to us, because we sensed that God was calling us to be here to help people to know Him, because we had experienced God's love and wanted to pass that on. You know, God so loved the world that He gave. That's principle behind this, that it's in giving we receive. We don't give so we can receive. It's we give, and God looks after us and He cares for us, and our giving shows our love for God. And so a question you can ask yourself and ponder on: does your giving reflect your value of who God is? That's a good question to ponder on in terms of your week, and think about. But you know, we've given of ourselves, our time, our energy, and our money, and we've called others to do the same. And I want to say today, thank you for everyone who's responded over the 31 years and go, yeah, we believe in this cause and we're going to help and contribute. So can we applaud everyone who's been part of this over this 31 years, and it's like, God, you're amazing. God, you are amazing. It's like, and that's why this is here, because it's a place where God and people meet. It's a space and a place. It's not that this is something unique, but it's a space where God and people can connect and God can touch people's lives. We're so grateful for what God has done and grateful for the lives that have been transformed by the power of His Spirit. We're seeing fathers' hearts turn to children and children to their fathers, families restored and freedoms, miracles. But you know, the best thing of all is people finding a real relationship with Jesus Christ. Yes. That has been the highlight of the journey over all of this time. So as we come to give to God, bring yourself, bring your finances, and maybe even God is speaking to you today about your future and His kingdom. Not just being a member of it, but being a person who helps others to know Him and be part of it. And you know, I was 16 when I just knew that God was asking me to do what I'm doing. So what's God stirring in your heart? And if God's stirring something in your heart, I'd love to chat with you and talk with you about that and encourage you and pray with you. Let's increase the balance sheet of heaven. The chief asset is people whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life.
Yeah. Very good. That's right.
Mm. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. That's all I got to say about that.
Let's pray.
I think we should pray. Jesus, bless every gift, every giver.
Yes, thank
Father,
you, God.
Every heart orientated towards you.
Thank you, Father.
God, we thank you for the cause of your kingdom. Mm. May your name be made famous throughout this Gold Coast. God, we thank you. We thank you, Father, for the 45 or so percent people that in the Gold Coast that say they're part of you, part of your family, the 44%. And Father, for the 43% of the people in the Gold Coast who say there's no religion in their life, God, I pray that you would turn up in their lives in visions and dreams, and that your people would have incredible conversations, and that, Father, that there'd be more and more people who come to know you. Father, let there be new churches birthed. Let there be increase in your churches in this place. Father, so that there's more people whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So a great song to sing today is the Lord's Prayer. I love this song because it's like, yes, Lord, let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And all the people are going, amen. And then after that, we've got the induction. So come on, let's stand to our feet and let's sing this song.
To temptation.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Woo! Man, you're singing like you believe it today. Man, how beautiful is that? So, Pastor Andrew, we're so blessed that you're here today to lead us in this time of induction and you want to?
Yes, there's an empty seat.
It's all right.
We'll pretend.
In the door.
See? Oh, great.
So being dad, first priority, dad.
Yep.
Second priority,
dad
to the church.
That's true. Yeah. Do you know what? I was remembering the other day, just a little quick thing in here.
Yeah.
I was remembering when we were in South Australia in a uniting church, so a big old building.
At York.
Josh was probably two at the most.
This high.
And he used to love calling out during the services because it echoed all around. He loved it. And he'd run down the aisle past Mrs. Sheriff. Oh, sorry if that's a relative, anyone. Mrs., one of the old ladies, and she would frown at him, and he'd stand there and look up at her. And she said to me after the service, "He's going to be a preacher like his dad." How prophetic was that? God uses all sorts of people to give prophecies. love you.
Andrew, in consultation with our board and the leadership of C3 Church, we're delighted to present Josh and Kate for induction here today. So God bless you and
thank you,
welcome
Andrew.
To the stage, sir. Let's give him a welcome.
Hey, come on, let's thank Pastors Don and Adrienne. How good? Wonderful, wonderful. Hey, you can grab your seats. And as well, let's thank the worship team. Thank you, guys. Do an amazing job. Well, what an absolute privilege and an honor it is to be here today as the baton is passed. And it's a very, very special day. And I'd like to join Pastors Don and Adrienne as well on giving a really special welcome to all of the C3 Robina Church family, both present but also past members as well that are here, also family members and friends of the Eastons who've traveled to be here today, as well as many from the extended family of our C3 Church movement who are here for this day. And this is a very special day in the life of the church here at C3 Robina. And I was thinking, this is such a time to actually to stop for a few moments to remember and to give thanks to the Lord for all the wonderful things that He's done in and through this church family over 31 years. And I think Don was speaking before and Adrienne so well that it is truly amazing to start to think about the hundreds upon hundreds of people over the years who have come into this church and they have been part of the story of C3 Robina. To think about all the people that have come here that have encountered Jesus in this place, all the people that have come here that have experienced God's miracle working power in their life, all the people that have come here and they've found hope, they've found faith, they've found freedom, they've found community, they've found purpose in this place as they've devoted their hearts to following Jesus, I think is truly remarkable and is part of the story of what God has done here. And it's also a time as well to think about and also to give thanks for all of the wonderful people who have been part of the story of C3 Church Robina, the incredible members of the church, but also as well the wonderful team of leaders and volunteers. And I want to thank them today because they've hosted us so well. Because could please thank all of our team that are serving here today. We appreciate you, love you so much. And this is what the church is built on. The church is built on the service, the love, the sacrifice, the devotion of so many people who've been part of building the house of God. And I was thinking, you know what, truly the story of C3 Robina is such a testament to both the goodness of God but also the faithfulness of people as well. And today we have the privilege of celebrating with Josh and Kate today, as in a few moments they're going to officially take up the mantle as the new senior pastors of C3 Robina. But also as well today, we not only want to honor this couple, which we will, but we want to honor a family as well, and that's the Easton family. And Pastors Don and Adrienne, I know that you've got a celebration and a mother party happening next week, but it would be remiss of me if I did not take a moment right now to commend you both for the exceptional job that you have done pioneering, building, and leading this church over 31 years. And Don and Adrienne, yeah, let's thank them. We honor you. And we celebrate you today, Don and Adrienne. Incredible. Don and Adrienne, you have served both God and the church here as senior pastors with distinction. And I want to commend you because you're a couple who lead as an incredible example to those around you. You've led by showing us what it means to walk by faith, to continue to love Jesus through every season of life. You've been an example of those who've always prayed and sought God first. You've been an example of what it means to persevere. You've been an example of what it means to hold on to the promises of God. You've been an example of what it is to love and care for the needs of others. And I think as well, today we stand testament to the example that you have shown us for your deep and abiding and faithful love for God's house. You have, as the scriptures commend us to do, laid down your own lives here for the sake of the gospel and to build God's house. And I know I speak on behalf of everyone that's here today, Don and Adrienne, to say we thank you for your work. We honor you here today. The foundations that you have laid upon this church will leave a wonderful legacy here for the next generation as they come through to build upon. And I'm telling you, this church will continue to thrive and flourish because of all that you have done. So we commend you again today, Pastors Don and Adrienne. We love you. And we pray God's richest blessing and favor on you both as you continue to serve him. We know the best is yet to come. And today we are recognizing the call of God upon Josh and Kate Easton. And it is a significant occasion today because what we are doing is we are recognizing and honoring God's gift of leadership to the church. And it is a gift. And today we will be commissioning Josh and Kate into this leadership role as the new senior pastors of C3 Robina. And I just think it's so right for us to celebrate today because this day is a significant day. This is a new day. This is the beginning of a new season for everyone who is part of the C3 Robina Church family. But you know what? Leadership in the scriptures is always a partnership. It's a partnership between God's people and those who've been appointed to lead. And so today I'm also inviting all of the members of C3 Robina to again renew your commitment and support to not only this wonderful church, but also to this wonderful couple, Josh and Kate, as they step into their new leadership role as senior partners, as senior pastors. And today, we are believing for God's continued favor and blessing and grace upon this church as it moves forward into the future under their leadership. In the book of Acts chapter 20 and verse 28, it says this. It says, "Keep watch over yourselves and over all the flock, of which the Holy Spirit has made you overseers. Be shepherds of the church of God, which he bought with his own blood." I love this passage because it tells us so clearly that what Jesus bought with his own blood was not only our forgiveness and salvation, but it says what he bought with his own blood is this right here, the church of God. And it says here, the Holy Spirit has chosen you. The Holy Spirit has appointed you. The Holy Spirit has anointed you to be overseers, to be shepherds of God's people. And let me say this, Josh and Kate, I think God's made a great choice in you both to lead this church. Josh and Kate, you're an amazing couple. In your own rights, you're an incredible role model of the church. You know, I think in how you both have partnered together, not just in marriage, not just in raising your kids, but the way you have served together and modeled that so well in ministry and leadership over so many years. And Josh and Kate, you just live it so well. Your genuine faith, your love for God, and your commitment and faithfulness to you both in the way in which you have served in the church in pretty much every capacity possible over the many years is an example to all of those around you. And I would say this too, over the last few years, Josh and Kate, I think we have all watched and seen how you have grown and developed into outstanding leaders in your own right. And it's so obvious that God's hand is on you both and that right now is the time, the right time to induct you as the new senior partners. And so we're going to move into the formal part of today. Josh and Kate, could I invite you both to come up onto the stage? Would you give them a big welcome? Come on, Josh and Kate. And so what we're going to do now, we're going to start with a charge. So in scriptures, it has charges that are given to leaders and how they are to lead and their character. And so today, Josh and Kate, we are recognizing here today the call of God upon you both to be pastors here at C3 Robina. You have been set by God in this place to go in before the people and to go out before the people. We recognize that the Holy Spirit has anointed you and appointed you as pastors here. And so today we charge you to live as Christ amongst his people and to live as the scriptures command you to live. We charge you to regularly and passionately seek God in prayer and the word so that you will be always filled with God's Spirit and that you will be anointed to lead this church in the demonstration and the power of God. We charge you today to be faithful shepherds and to keep watch over God's own people, the church. And we charge you today to lead this church always in a spirit of faith, hope, and love. And now we're going to invite Josh and Kate to make a pledge. It's kind of like the wedding vows, really, but yeah.
We will. Okay.
Almost 14 years to the day.
Oh, yeah. Whoa. 14 years married almost. All right, here we go.
Let's do it.
We, Joshua and Katrina Easton, do solemnly pledge that from this day on, we will lead and pastor God's flock, not out of compulsion, but freely. According to God's will, we will do this eagerly, not lording it over those who entrusted to us, but by being an example to the church. We will preach the word of God in season and out of season, when it is convenient and when it is not convenient. We will protect this church from those in error and those who seek to do harm. We will lead this church in a spirit of faith, hope, and love.
How good. Look how in sync they were with that. That's amazing right there. Incredible, incredible. So Josh and Kate, why don't you step over here? That's there. Josh and Kate Easton, I declare before God and before this congregation here today that you are now being inducted as the new senior pastors of C3 Church Robina. I therefore command you today, according to the words spoken, funnily enough, in the book of Joshua. Might be called the book of Josh and Kate, but here we go. These are the words from the book of Joshua. It says, be strong, be very courageous, be careful to obey all of God's word, and do not turn from it to the right or to the left, so that you may be successful wherever you go. Study the word of God continually, meditate on it both day and night, so that you will be sure to obey everything written in it, for then you will prosper and succeed in everything you do. This is my command, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or discouraged, for the Lord your God will go with you wherever you go. And so now I would like to invite Pastors Don and Adrienne Easton and also the church board to join us up on stage. I'd also like to ask all of the church to stand as we join together to pray and anoint Josh and Kate. Josh Church, I'd like to just invite you to join in prayer right now. Would you stretch out your hands today and pray for them today? Heavenly Father, today, we thank you that this is a sacred moment. Lord God, we thank you today for your church, the church of God. And we thank you, Father, that your word says that you have placed Josh and Kate here as overseers, as shepherds of your people. And Heavenly Father, we commit them to you today. And Lord God, we pray today, let your anointing come upon them, Father, in a new way, in a new measure today. Lord, we pray that you would pour out your Spirit upon them afresh. We pray that you would fill them today with wisdom. You would fill them with grace. Father, I pray that you would fill them today with new dreams and visions. Father, we thank you today, God, that the power of the Holy Spirit is upon them. Heavenly Father, we thank you today, God. We pray, Lord, that you would continue, Lord, to go with them every step that they take. We pray, God, that they would know, Lord, your grace and your goodness that goes with them every single day. Father, we pray today. We pray that you would stir them afresh in the call of God that is upon them, God. We pray today, let that mantle of leadership, let that mantle of grace would be upon them today. And Father, we pray and we commit them to you, God. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for the 31 years of your goodness, God, that has been marked over this church. We thank you, Lord, for the hundreds and hundreds of lives that have been transformed by Jesus in this place. But God, today we thank you, Lord. This is also a day to look to the future. Lord, we thank you today, God, that you have, God, set before them, God, new paths and new dreams and new visions, God. We thank you, Lord, today that your hand will be upon them, God, in every decision they make, God, in every way that they go. And Father, we thank you today, God, for the greatness of your purposes and your plans for them. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Pastor Don, can I ask you to pray?
Jesus, thank you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for a double anointing. Yes, Father, Father, what you put on me, let it be double on Josh and Kate. What you put on Adrian, let it be double on Josh and Kate. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father.
Wonderful. Josh and Kate, this is like the moment in the wedding where we announce this is the moment. Josh and Kate, come on, let's join in celebrating the new senior pastors, C3 Robina, Josh and Kate Easton. Amazing. You're going to be incredible. Wonderful. Well, we've had the prayer, we've had the anointing, but we need a cake. All right, got to have a cake. It's not official without a cake. So we're going to have the cake cutting right now. Yeah, that's good. So here it comes. We're going to swap out the anointing oil. And look at this cake. Come on.
Oh, that's great. We love you. Thank you so much for being here today. This is very surreal. And I think all day, I think we should have had this in the morning so we don't have to wait so long all day. Just waiting for this moment. Why don't you have a seat? We just want to say a couple of things. First of all, thank you so much for everyone being here. It means so much for us to have you with us to celebrate this moment, to celebrate our church, to celebrate our founding pastors, to celebrate God's goodness, to celebrate Jesus. So thank you so much, Pastor Andrew, for being here, for helping, for coordinating this. It has meant so much to us, to me especially, because I've known you for so long, right, when I was a young youth pastor, and you took me under your wing and you were brilliant in training me in leadership, even from that point. Take the mic whenever you lead. Yeah, okay, good. I want to say thank you to Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for his love for us, for his leadership to this moment, for the plan that you can see clearly orchestrated through all of our lives, through the fact that we were born to the people we were born with, that we were, how we met, of how we heard the voice of God so clearly that we would take this church on, right through to how he looked after us in our times of trouble, right through to our daily bread. It means so much to know that just as he has started a good work in us, that he will carry it on to completion in Christ Jesus. It means so much that we can stand confidently up here, not because it is a whim that we are here today, but because it was a seed of a dream planted in my heart when I was 10. It means so much that I can see the continuation of God's plan, not just up until this point, but way stretching into the future. I feel at home in this place, but also in God's plan. And the fact that Jesus would choose me and choose us with all our faults and to entrust us with you, with this glorious church, it is astounding. I'm overwhelmed by the grace of God. I think if we can trust in anything, it's that. It's Christ's love for us and his love for his church, because he sweated and he died for it. He dropped blood for it. So thank you so much, Jesus. Can we give God a round of applause? Thank you so much to our yeah?
Sure. I just want to say a big thank you to our children, Xander and Gabby. We love you so much. You guys are amazing, being pastors' kids. You know, you put in a lot of effort, a lot of time too, and we say thank you, and thank you that they are so excited to be along on this journey with us. I can't tell you how excited they are. And I just wanted to say thank you to my mum, to Stuart, to my dad, to our parents, yes. your parents. Yeah, yeah. It's incredible, mum, you do so much for us and help us so much so that we can do what we do here. So thank you.
Well done. Well, let's continue saying thank you to Pastor Don and Adrian, and especially thanks, Mum and Dad. Thanks. We've shared you as a spiritual Mum and Dad with the church, but to have you as our spiritual role models, growing up and seeing the reality of your faith-filled journey, that you'd teach us to pray, not rote prayers, but pray in a way that would touch the heart of God and we would know him. Thank you. Thank you for setting a climate in our own family, but in our church, a one which is where God would meet people, like you said before. A catch cry that so dear to your heart. Thank you for saying yes to Jesus and moving from Adelaide, from coming up. Thank you for not letting your grade 11 and 12 experience stop you from taking up the call of God and saying, if I can do it, then of course we can build a church. Thank you for your faith. And thank you for pioneering this church. Thank you for taking great risks. Thank you for demonstrating courageous faith. Thank you for creating an environment where people would dare to believe what God would have for them, would dare to believe that they could actually change the world. We are all indebted to your belief in us, given obviously by God's belief in you. So thank you so much. We say thank you to our church family. Hey, church. Hey, family. Because it takes a lot of people to build a church, and you are miraculous. You are marvelous. The way you love one another, the way you're devoted to the scriptures, the way you're devoted to Jesus, the way you believe the best in one another, the way you cover up wrongs and forgive so quickly, the way you jump in to help one another in times of need. You blow us away. You are profoundly wonderful. And this is such a treasure that we get to now be watching from the sidelines, watching right next to you, watching on the pitch with you to see the firsthand view of God's miraculous changes in God, in your life that are about to happen, that are going to happen in the years to come. So thank you for loving one another, and thank you for loving Jesus. And thank you for accepting us as your new senior pastors. Thank you for cheering us on. Thank you for your encouragement. So cool. Good. What are we looking forward to? I've said a few times over the last few weeks since we announced that we have this profound feeling that a foundation, a solid foundation, deep roots have been laid in this place by our founding pastors, by all of us. Deep roots that are going to harvest a huge tree. You will be amazed by the trees that are produced by this church. The days are coming where the fruit from this place is going to feed the nations. The leaves are going to be for the healing of the people. The future of this place is going to be wonderful. And I'm so excited to see how that is going to come about in us as we partner together, as we continue to pursue and push into Jesus and push into each other's lives to go and seek and save the lost like Christ did and gather them and bring them home. I can't wait for this. In Psalm 84, it says, they go from strength to strength until each one appears before God in Zion. That's us. We take the strength that we've got, the solid foundations, and it's only going to produce more of the same, more of the wonderful encouragement, more of the place of hope and healing, more of a place of family, more of generations entrusting and teaching God's word to the next, more of that. I can't wait for that. 2 Corinthians 3:18 says that he transformed into his likeness with ever-increasing glory. That's us, church. You will be amazed when you look back even to this moment by the changes that you would have made just because we continue to love one another, because we continue to love Jesus, because we continue to push and build this wonderful church. And I am sure of this, that he who began a good work in us, right back in 1992, when Pastor Gordon Moore came and preached to inaugurate our church, to inaugurate Pastor Don and Adrian, our founding pastors, right back at that point, even before that, when the seed of the dream was given to Pastor Don and Adrian, I am confident of this, that he who began a good work in us will carry it on to completion in the day of Christ Jesus our Lord. So our commitment to you, apart from the charge as well, it's extrapolating. Our commitment to you is that we will be gardeners of this great garden. That we will spend our days cultivating an environment in which you can flourish. We'll eliminate the weeds. We'll bring you to the truth, bring you to the water of life. We'll bring you to health. We'll get healthy together. And we'll create space for our friends and family to come and find hope and healing in this place, to find new purpose, so they can be strong oaks of righteousness, trees that bear great fruit in Jesus' name. We're going to teach you how to feed yourself and feed others, teach you how to love one another and follow Christ. And if anything, if we could give you anything, it would be a demonstration of a pursuit of Jesus, because he is worth it all. And we will spend our lives pursuing him. And we'd ask that you would come with us on the journey. In Jesus' name, let's go. Great. I don't think we could have been anything else. Yeah. I think God ordained us to be pastors.
I never would have thought when I was a little girl. You were like, he's going to be a preacher man. I'm like, never would have thought that.
Yeah.
A few years ago, I found out through my great uncle in Germany who did our genealogy. He was like, if you become a pastor one day, you'll be number 65. Number one female.
Brilliant. Love it. So will you come on this crazy journey with us? Let's do this. Thank you so much as well to our wider C3 community, our wider pastors and friends and family who could be with us as well. Thanks so much for being here. We're so blessed by your friendship, by the fact that you're backing us up and you're supporting us in this. We are going to change the world. C3 is going to change the world. I am so convinced that we are going to bring a new move, a new outpouring of God's presence through our lives as we love God and love one another. Thank you so much, church. We can't wait to do this with you. Please welcome Tash and Steph. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for all you've done to pull this together today. You're incredible. Thank you.
Thanks. Hey, church. We just want to thank you so much again for coming to share this special day with us, everyone that traveled. And we just want to take this moment just to really take up a love offering for Pastor Andrew. So Pastor Andrew is our area director for Queensland and Northern New South Wales. And we just want to take this moment just to really thank him for traveling out here and just being part of this really significant day in our church. And for me, Pastor Andrew is actually my pastor. I moved here from Bridgman Down. So I know him very well. And so I just want to really... take this moment just to honour him. So there's some ways to give on the screen, and the team will also be passing around some buckets to give. And yeah, Pastor Andrew, we just want to thank you for taking part of this day. And I know Josh and Kate really want to thank you as well just for being part of this really special moment. So after the service, we've got heaps of stuff happening.
Yes, we do. Thank you all for coming. It's so great to see everybody here. We would like to invite you to come and have dinner with us. So there is a taco truck up the top of the driveway there with food and drink available for you to purchase. So please support them, supporting us, support everybody. Everyone's just having a great time. Stay, please stay. There's free cake and coffee. Everyone loves free coffee and our coffee is good here. So please, please stay for cake and coffee. If you have brought children here today, we would like to invite them into room 2. So if that's just at the second black sign, there's a little hallway there. At the end of that, you'll see a big lots of children and follow the smell of the pizza. There's pizza there for the kids. We just ask that you sign your children in and out. If there's an issue, one of the kids' church team will come and get you, but please sign them in or out so that we can keep track of our little amazing future of the church.
Yeah, awesome.
That's my job.
So yeah, stick around. It's going to be a party outside as we keep celebrating. And next week, we're going to have another week of celebrations. So,
yes, we are.
Yeah.
Please come back.
So part 2. So next week, we're going to take a moment to really honour Pastor Don and Adrian. Just for their leadership over the last 31 years since they founded C3 Robina. So it's going to be a massive celebration as well. We're going to have lunch provided, so please make sure you do register and RSVP just so we can make sure we have enough food and seats for you. And after that service, so that is a 9:30 a.m. service. So come along in the morning, same as our normal service. Afterwards, we'll have lunch. There's going to be heaps of other stuff in the cafe, like a balloon artist, face painting. Woo! Not just for the kids, come on.
Yeah.
I'll be out there.
I'm going to get in that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And we're going to have lawn games and stuff out there as well. So come along next week as well, and we're going to have another week. Before we head out into the cafe, we just want to finish with a really fun song. So let's jump to our feet and let's have one more song.
Blessed, everybody. Enjoy your night socializing with everyone.